Siguro hindi na kasi lumipas na yun eh. Yung sa ibang tao, pwedeng imbestigahan. Pero pag lumipas na, parang hindi na pinapansin.
Dapat. Kasi hindi natin maitatama yung magiging future, yung kasalukuyan natin. Kung yung past na pagkakamali, hindi maitatama. Paimbestigahan natin, okay.
Siyempre, mahal ang imbestigahan para malaman, di ba? Lilitaw yung katotohanan. Kasi kahit naman nakalipas, importante pa rin yun para maparusahan yung mga nagkasala.
Natural lang kailangan maimbestigahan para malaman natin ang katotohanan.
Welcome back. Our question, should the government probe alleged election cheating in 2004 and 2007? And you felt the pulse of the people we interviewed and our friends on Twitter. Let's get back to this five-minute round. Let me ask you individually. Let's start with you, Attorney Rona. What do you think must be the focus of this investigation of 2004 and 2007?
The focus of the investigation must be, look at who committed the election offenses. People must be held accountable for what they committed in the 2004 and 2007 elections.
Okay. And do you think, Attorney, that that is possible with the kind of joint investigative bodies that will be formed by the DOJ and the COMELEC just to find probable cause?
It is very much possible, but I would like to look at the third purpose, yes. And that is looking at our system of responding to complaints and adjudication of election disputes. You know, if we have a very sound election dispute and complaints process, then we would have addressed these issues in real time. Mm-hmm. Okay? Then people, then complainants would be more willing to come out. Yeah. The problem is that the system is so backward. Mm-hmm. That, you know, it does not respond to complaints, to legitimate complaints of anomalies, of miscounting, of being cheated. And that is why it's kind of ironic that complainants or witnesses comes out when the term is already over.
Yeah.
So we should change the system.
Yeah. Howie, what about...
Well, you? We have to remember that the basis of our democracy is a good and sound and honest elections, which I think all the four here, all of us have been fighting for. And I think that is why we need really to look at what happened in 2004, 2007, not only just to know who the winner is. That is secondary. It's really, there's a criminal liability here, number one. Number two, we have to learn from the mistakes. And number three, we have to move forward. Do we still go to that system? Or as we have been pushing in the COMELEC, and all us here, are we going to push all ahead for an automated election system, which we have seen in 2010 was a better alternative than the 2004 and the 2007. So I think it's learning from the mistakes, letting those people pay for those mistakes, and moving forward to have a better democracy and a cleaner elections.
Yeah. Did you have to wait for Asaldi Apa 212? More or less trigger this whole issue of looking back at the 2004 and 2007? Was not COMELEC already looking into the election offenses?
Yeah, we were. Actually, I was. Personally, I wanted to go back to 2004 to check on Garcia. But you see, we did not really have anybody. No witnesses were coming out. It's very difficult to look for people 7 years back. The coming out of Saldi actually precipitated all of this, especially now that Bitol came in for 2007, and then Garcia started to send fillers according to Malacanang, which I don't really know, and that actually precipitated everything. And since I really wanted to go back to put a closure, that's the purpose, to put a closure, because since 2004 up to the present, there were so many investigations conducted, but nothing came out of it. None. There was nobody charged for any violation or any electoral offense committed in 2004. And I was so frustrated because I was the lawyer of PJ and Loren. And I just thought that maybe when I'm there and now I'm here as chairman, maybe just look at it. No, not for the purpose of really going after those, but just to see, ano ba talaga nangyari? What really happened? And I was sure, because I know of certain matters which were there were cheatings committed, but I could not do anything because I don't really have the witnesses.
But now, is it a difficult role for you now to play as chairman of COMELEC and being the legal counsel of both?
Somehow, people are already talking about my inhibition, and I said, okay, I will have to inhibit ultimately if it will have to go up to the commission and bank, where I am the chairman, where I'll have to vote. I'll probably not vote anymore, because by that time, I hope we will be able to convince at least six of our members, a collegial body, that they would agree.
But can you appear as a resource person or as a witness? Or
as a witness, although I'm praying that I don't have to appear anymore. No?
And would you be surrendering your documents?
Yes. In fact, Tina, evidence? Right now, we're collating all of the documents that we have in the Commission on Elections, as well as my own private documents.
You will contribute to that because you were a lawyer.
Yes. I'm talking to my former law office partners, because we have the documents there. So we're now collating everything, including documents in the possession of Senator Legarda. Yeah. She has some documents also. Okay. We will collate all of this.
So how long is this preliminary investigation and finding probable cause going to take
for the COMELEC and the DOJ? The joint commission, we hope to set it up within the week.
Okay.
Within the week, then we can start by next week. We'll start checking first all the names. We are now reviewing all the people that we can subpoena as witnesses or those who are willing to come out as witnesses, and then finish this all in 6 months.
How many more are there waiting and knocking at your doors to reveal more?
There are several, but I would not really like to mention. We're trying to check on everything, like, for example, military people who were involved in the 2004 who are now retired. Mm-hmm. But who can now start to speak about what they have happened, whether they participated or not. Former Commission on Elections officials or former election officers of the Commission on Elections and all other BEIs who can attest to certain anomalies.
Can they also send feelers to you? I mean,
In fact, Garcia, I've been inviting him to come out and just call me up so we can meet.
Okay.
And they just want him to open up. Anyway, I said it's already a different administration. I was not referring to Malacanang. I was referring to a different administration at the Commission on Elections.
Okay, thank you very much, Chairman Attorney Sixto Brillantes, for joining us. Attorney Rona, Attorney Luie, and Attorney Hawa, always good to have you here on the program. That's all the time we have. Talk to us again next week on Talkback.